Hello YouTube, it's Tuesday, May 17th, and I thought I'd go through and see what Donnie's looking at. Donnie says he's found Nibiru. Yeah, he says he's found Nibiru outside of Neptune. Okay, so what's he looking at here? Well, he's got Microsoft Worldwide Telescope here, and looking at a pretty big area of the sky. He's got the search area up here, but you don't want to pay any attention to those numbers there. What you want to pay attention to are these numbers right down here. These numbers tell you where you're looking. And if he goes to the WISE survey, now if you ever know anything about these surveys, they're taken at a certain time and they're not updated. In other words, when you go to one of these surveys, you're looking at something from a set time. And so what you have to do is you have to go back to the object, the satellite that was taking the survey, and look at when they made the survey and look at what that area of the sky that you're looking at, and it'll tell you what time they made the survey. So we can do that here, and say you're looking through here with the WISE All Sky Survey, and he's zooming in there on this object that looks really nice and bright there. And if you look down here, he's got the cursor on the position there, and it's about 0 hours, 8 minutes, 31 seconds, and 0 degrees, -0 degrees, 27 minutes, and 6 seconds. So what's he looking at there? Well, it's nothing right now, because this is the WISE survey. It was conducted back in 2010. So we need to go back to WISE and figure out what time he was looking at this. So we can do that by going back and putting a position in. And I put the position in here. We can go back a step there and look at it. Here's the position right there. 0 hours, 9 minutes, 18 seconds, -0 degrees, 32 minutes, 25 seconds. And if we take and we go ahead from there, we're going to get what I just had. And basically what you're looking at is a picture from June 22nd, 2010 at 14:39. Well, why is that important? Well, it's important because when you're taking a deep sky survey and you're having something that's close to the Earth doing it, like WISE is, circling the Earth, by the way, you're going to find things out there that are bigger and bright because they're close. And those things that are big and bright because they're close, well, it was gone over back in this video here a while back. And remember the old blackout skies? Google Sky, WikiSky, and Worldwide Telescope had a problem with blacking things out, and it was a big conspiracy. Well, this was made back in 2009. And they blacked out a part of the IRS survey, and the reason they blacked it out was because there was something big and bright there, and it made a really bad show. There was two of them because it took two scans, and the thing had moved in between the scans, and it moved and had a double image there, so they blacked it out. Well, what was that? It was Saturn. Yeah, Saturn is close to you, so when you're trying to look out at a deep sky and you run the camera across Saturn, you're going to get a big surprise. So what is Donnie looking at here? Okay, so we went back and we looked at it, and this particular area of the sky that he's looking at was imaged in 2010, 622. So let's go back and see what was there. Look at that. Jupiter. Yes, this is June 22nd, 2010, 1439. And if we look at the position of Jupiter as viewed from the WISE satellite, I went back and loaded an old satellite file, and I think it was from 2011, around in January. Didn't have one from 2010. WISE was here, and I got a satellite orbit for close to the same time. And when WISE was looking out there at this time and this position, this is what it saw. And this just happened to be at RA 0 hours, 8 minutes, 22.5 seconds, minus 0 degrees, 26.53. So what WISE is looking at here, and you're seeing on Donnie's video, that right there, that's Jupiter. Here's the position right here. This is a WISE survey. The WISE survey was taken back on that date. So what you're looking at right there is Saturn. So what about the other one? Okay, he's got two of them. He found two of them. Okay, so let's go ahead. I think it's at time 23:37. Kind of news on finding Jupiter there, Donnie. That's a really, really big thingy there. Okay, 23. Right around in here. Again, he's looking at the whole sky there, just about big area anyway. So he switches over to Wise and he zooms in on this one. Hey, that looks pretty close to the same one, except for the flares going off the other way. So he's got the position there, 1156, 31, positive 3 degrees, 36. Okay, so it's the same thing. We're going to have to go back to Wise here and see what Wise was looking at back then. And here we go. We can back it up one spot here. And here's 11 hours, 56 minutes, 38 seconds, plus 3 degrees, 42 minutes. And we can take and run that ahead. And you can change this, by the way. And I change it to degrees. Every time you go back, it goes to the default. But if you look over here, this particular area of the sky, Wise was looking at it on 6/11, 2010, 12/44. So what was where Wise was looking back then? So we go to our program again, and we look up that particular position on that particular date, June 11, 2010, 12/44. We have Saturn. Kunduz, Donnie, you have found Saturn. Yes. We take and we look at the position of Saturn on that date and time. It is 11 hours, 55 minutes, 43 seconds, and positive 3 degrees, 3 minutes, and 58 seconds. You have found Saturn. That's really impressive, Donnie. So, the two objects that Donnie has on his video here that he's calling Nubaru are not blacked out this time. Remember the big stink about blacking out stuff the last time? Yeah, that was over here. Video from back in 2009, blacked out areas of the sky because it had nasty stuff in there. Basically, it was real bright stuff that was really messing up the deep sky survey because it was close and they were moving. So anyway, well, they didn't block it out this time. And anyone with half a brain and can figure it out. Like I say, these surveys are taken at a certain time. You can go back and look at Wise. It was only active for a certain time frame. These pictures were taken back then, and they're not updated. The thing is not taking any more pictures. It only took it on this certain date. And on this particular position right here, on this particular date, you were looking at Jupiter. And on this particular position, Wise took the shot back on 6/11/2010 at 12:44. And you were looking at Saturn. There it is right there, Saturn. The other one over here is Jupiter. So I think Nubaru is still at large. I don't really think you're going to find it, though. Look at this article that people keep talking about here. They don't mention this thing right up there, the big question mark at the end. See that big question mark right there? That's a question mark. The thing is, all this is the calculations. As he's just said that something's perturbing. He thinks something is perturbing the outer Kuiper belt objects, and a planet would fit that description really good. So he is talking about that. But if you go through here and look at it, all it is calculations, and he doesn't have a clue about where to find it. At least when Harrington came up with his Planet X, and when Stitchin came up with his Nubaru, they gave you an idea of where to find them. Both of those, by the way, Planet X is outbound, according to the person that the theorized it, has never been found. And the person that theorized it placed it on an outbound orbit. And Stitchin also, nothing's been found, and he theorized it, and he even said it wouldn't be back for 3440 AD is the next time that he thinks it's going to be back. So there's nothing been found here, and if you look at that, it says right there, planet's pretty dim. Yeah, anything far out is dim. Simulations, it's a simulation, doesn't give astronomers any clue about where to point their telescopes. It can be anywhere. At least Harrington and Stitchin gave us a pretty good idea of where to look. This guy doesn't give us anything. And if you, this is nothing new, by the way. If you go back and look at some of the old Mike Brown videos here, he has this one here. He was talking about a Mars or even an Earth-sized object being out far reaches of the Kuiper Belt back in 2007, 5 years ago. And you can go at about this time on this video here. I'll put the link down below. It's kind of a bad one. The audio's messed up. They had a better one on there, but it's been pulled apparently for some reason. Anyway, that's what it is. Donnie's looking at Saturn. He's looking at Jupiter. He thinks he's found Nibiru. When he's sitting on a park bench with his laptop looking at WISE photos that thousands of scientists have looked at and haven't been able to find Nibiru yet. Donnie found it, though. He found it sitting on that park bench while he's looking for a home, and what he found was Jupiter and Saturn, but if you want to believe that, go ahead. He found Nibiru. Of course, astronomers say he didn't, but that's a big conspiracy, too. Anyway, so we'll talk to you next time.